This video will cover the Group Management Dashboard. This section of service allows you to add or manage groups, search and communicate with volunteers in certain groups, and register groups for volunteer activities. If you would like to learn how to add new groups, please view the video that is linked in the description. You can find the Group Management Dashboard by clicking on Group Management under the Attribute Management heading of the main dashboard. From this menu, you can search for a particular group or groups by using any of the standard options, advanced options, or the search box on the top right. You can use the buttons to the left of each group name to take actions for that group. The leftmost button takes you to the main menu for the group that we will look at later. You can use the next button to go directly to the screen to register the group for events. The next three buttons will take you to the Volunteer Management Dashboard displaying particular search results. The first one will show you all volunteers that are associated with this group. The second will show volunteers that are only associated with this group and no others. And the last will show you all volunteers that are not associated with this group. Let's look at the main menu for a group by clicking the button to manage the group. The first option is to view or update the group information, where you can take actions, such as updating the group contact or changing their group status from active to inactive. The next option will take you to the menu where you can register the group for events. A registration from this screen is a bulk anonymous registration, where you are registering a certain number of volunteers from this group for a particular activity, but you will not know who the individuals are or collect their personal information. The next option takes you to the menu we were just looking at. If a group is registered for a service project, this next option allows you to log hours for them. Next, you can view the volunteers that are associated with this group and add or remove members. You can see if there are any file attachments associated with this group or add them from this menu. Lastly, you can view or add any group notes here on the right. Back on the Group Management menu, there are a few more actions that you can take near the bottom of the screen. To take any of these actions, you will first need to select one or more groups, depending on the action you are taking, by clicking the checkbox next to the group names. The Update Group button will take you directly to the menu to update the basic details for a particular group. Manage Group will take you to the main menu for that group. Show Members will take you to the Volunteer Management menu, displaying the members of all the groups you selected. The Show Leaders button will take you to the Volunteer Management menu, displaying the group contacts from the group or groups that you select. The Group Spreadsheet button will download a CSV file with the basic group information as well as the contact information for the primary and alternate group contacts. If you need to delete a group, you can use the Remove Groups button. Note that you cannot delete a group if they have any hours associated with them, so you would need to remove any registration history before deleting the group. You should not typically need to delete groups. Instead, we recommend marking groups as inactive to notate they are no longer working with you. This ensures you do not lose any history associated with the group you may want to report on later. You can also bulk update the information for multiple groups at once. For example, you can mark multiple groups as inactive at the same time. Lastly, if you find that you have two of the same groups in your system, you can merge them into one. This video is one in a series of videos on group management within service. Follow the link in the description for a playlist of all of the videos.